plants. Identification of parts of the plant. There are variations in the size and shape of plants, but generally all plants have roots, stems and leaves. Different types of roots. In some plants, the main root becomes thick and has thin rootlets. This main root is known as taproot, and the rootlets are called lateral roots. In some plants, we find small hair-like roots arising from the base of the stem. This type of root stem is known as fibrous root. Here, all roots are similar and there is no main root. Functions of the root. Roots help to fix the plant tightly to the soil, so we can pull out the plants easily from the soil. Absorption of water. Roots help in taking up of water from the soil. They do this by absorption. Minerals present in the soil are also absorbed along with water. Take 2 glass tumblers filled with water. Collect 2 plants having soft stems along with their roots. Add color in one of the tumblers. Place the plant in each of the tumbler. Let them be for 2 to 3 hours. We can conclude that roots help in taking up water from the soil. They do this by absorption. Tuberous roots. Some plants like radish, carrot, beetroot store food material in their roots. These roots bulge out and called tuberous roots. Parts of a leaf. Leaves are another important parts of plants. Plants that we see in our surroundings have different types of leaves. A leaf contains leaf base, a stalk-like structure called petiole and lamina. The leaf lamina usually consists of a midrib, veins and vinolets arranged in the form of a network. Venation. You may see some thin line-like structures spread over the leaf. These lines on the leaf are called veins. The long vein present in the middle of the lamina is called midrib. The branches arising from the midrib are called veins, and the even finer divisions are venolets. The arrangement of veins in the lamina is called ventation. Ventation acts as a skeleton of the leaf and gives it a shape and support. Types of ventation. The plants with taproot system have leaves with web-like or reticulate ventation, and plants with fibrous roots have parallel ventation. Functions of a leaf. Leaves play an important role in the life of plants. Stomata observations. Take a fleshy leaf. Peel the outer layer of the leaf and place it on a slide. Put a drop of water on it and observe it under a microscope. We find some bean-shaped parts. The bean-shaped part in the leaf acts like our nose. These are called stomata. Full in the exchange of gases between the plant and atmosphere. Transpiration. Plants release excess water in their body through stomata and some other parts. The water is released in the form of vapor, and this process is called transpiration. On a bright summer day, select a well-watered plant that has been growing in the sun. Enclose a leafy branch of the plant in a polythene bag and tie up its mouth. Take another polythene bag of the same size and tie up its mouth without keeping any plant. Keep both the polythene bags in the sun. After a few hours, we find droplets of water in the bag which is tied to a plant. Photosynthesis. Another leaf function is the preparation of food for the plant by the process of photosynthesis. Stem. The water and food material absorbed by the root is carried through the stem to all parts of the plant. The stem branches into sub-branches and bears leaves, flowers and fruits. Take two small cuttings from a soft-stemmed plant. Set them in a beaker of water. Add 2 to 3 drops of red ink in one beaker. Wait for 2 to 3 hours. Cut a small section of the stem of the plant kept in red ink and water with a sharp blade. Put it on a slide. On observing under a microscope, the colored ring-like structure that you see act as a tube that carries water and food material throughout the plant. The water absorbed by the root is carried through the stem to all parts of the plant. Some plants like potato, turmeric, garlic and sugarcane store food material in the stem, due to which the stem bulges in size. Generally, we think that these are all tubers or roots. Actually, they are modified stems. Flowers. Flower is another important part of the plant. Flower has different colorful structures called petals. They attract insects for pollination and produce fruits. We grow plants for colorful flowers, which gives beauty to the nature.
మా వీడియో గనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి. ఇలాంటి మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోవడం మాత్రం మర్చిపోకండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ వాచింగ్.